Hey my lovelies, welcome back to my channel. Welcome to my new subscribers. Thank you for being here. So this reading came to me the other day and I thought, you know what, let's have a go. So obviously the title says who's giving you the side eye. So for some of you who don't know what the side eye is, it's some, you know, that look when you give someone, you know, look to the side with your eyes. But it's also somebody that is questioning your intentions, silently judging you, criticizing you. You know, it is a bit like hate, really. So yeah, there you go. I think I've explained it. So we've got no crystals, no nothing, even though I've got crystals there, but anyway. So group one, you've got this eye card here. Group two, you've got this one. Group three, and this one. Okay, so tell what resonates, leave what doesn't. And don't forget, these are energies that I do as well. So if the King of Swords comes out, that can be either or, okay? And if I'm reading, say, the Queen of Cups card, I'm going to say she because it's a she card, even though, you know, if you don't resonate with that, that's fine. But it's so much easier to just keep sticking with, you know, what's on the card because it gets confusing. So anyway, I'll see you at your piles. Hey group one, so I've not looked at anybody's cards here, so I don't even know what flew out for you guys. Okay, so you know, let's go from there. So the person that's giving you the side eye, what are they thinking about you, okay, with this card? So this person thinks you're a people pleaser, okay, and you have bad habits. Okay, let's have a look. Interesting. If I can get it in there. Okay, so tell me, spirit, tell me more about group one and the person or the people that are giving group one the side eye. Why is group one getting the side eye? God, blimey. Okay, really? So we have the Page of Cups, the World, Ace of Wands, Three of Wands, Eight of Cups, Four of Cups, and the Hierophant. On the back of the deck, we have the Knight of Pentacles. So whoever's giving you the side eye has been side eyeing you for a very long time, okay? You know, the side eye is usually someone, like I said in the intro, they don't usually tell you what they think about you, okay? It's like they keep it to themselves, you know, two-faced. Whoever this is that gives you the side eye, they find you very immature. They think that you're a gossip, okay? You know, yeah. Yeah. They feel like you're someone that will bell, you know. Let me explain that, because that's I don't know whether you guys understand that word. So bailing on something, you know, it's when you say you're going to go somewhere, to say like a party or meet someone at the pub. You're one of these people that are really flighty, okay, that you just bail on them just like that, like no explanation. I'm not doing this, okay, I'm not going to be there. And and I feel like this is what the habit is here. Even though you've got the people pleaser, you've also got this bad habit of just not pitching up or saying where you're going to be. Also, person's giving you the side eye because they think you're really envious of them. They think you're really jealous of them, okay? And I feel like the reason why they feel like you're jealous of them is because it could be that this person gets to travel more. It could be this person may be some kind of influencer, you know, some influence that can go to their heads, you know. They feel, yeah, this person side-eyes you because they feel like you don't succeed in anything. You don't stick to nothing. it's like you're full of all this these bright ideas, and but you never follow through with it. You always, you start something but you don't finish it, okay? Yeah, look, we've got the envy again here. This person feels like that you want group one what they have, like maybe the relationship that they've got, or the wealth that they've got, or the success that they've got. It's like they feel like you are literally pining over their life. Whoever this is has got a right big ego. Bear with me, okay? Okay. Nearly swore there out loud. What I'm getting from this as well, guys, group one, is this person feels like you're boring, okay, with the Four of Cups, that you just don't bring them, you don't do anything for them. But you know what? What's confusing me here, okay? I'm going to clarify that, because we do have the Eight of Cups. And it's like this energy is like saying to me, is that I really want to walk away from group one, but I can't. It's like they're saying I feel stuck. But why are you stuck? You can, you know, if you don't like someone, you don't have to hang around with them. They feel like this person is really judgy. They feel like you're look, it's gonna get a bit personal here, okay? So don't attack the tarot reader here, but they judge you for your religious background, okay, or your ethnicity, okay? They side-eye you. I feel like this person may be a bit racist towards some of you, so you know, this may be narrowing down who this is to you. So we do have Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, Taurus, and yeah, let me have a look. I want to know what this Eight of Cups is. See, now the Eight of Cups as well could be, you know, they this energy saying that you don't stick to anything. It's like you start something new and then it's like I can't be bothered anymore. So that could be what it is that you constantly are walking away from, you know, responsibilities or ideas or something like that. Tell me about the Eight of Cups. Cards. Okay, let's shove that up there, because there are a lot of cards. So this is clarifying the Eight of Cups, okay? So we have the Knight of Swords, Two of Cups, Ten of Wands, Ace of Cups, the Hermit, Eight of Swords, Two of Wands, Six of Pentacles. Okay, group one, okay, for some of you, I feel like this is your partner, okay? I feel like it is, but, you know, it may not, because we do have the Two of Cups and we do have the Ace of Cups here. You know, you could even be married to this person. And you know, and I'm clarifying the Eight of Cups, and that is, like I said, this person wants to walk away, but they feel stuck. They feel like they can't walk away from you. So I'm really strongly going with my intuition here, and it is a partner to you. You know, don't get me wrong, sometimes we don't really ever admit what we're really feeling, and it towards our partners, because that just would be a bit harsh, isn't it? I mean, this could be you side-eyeing your partner, but it is mainly a reading for who is actually side-eyeing you, okay? You can swap it around if you want. So this is somebody that feels like you, yeah, you know when I said about the flightiness, not sticking to something. So it's like you go all gung-ho, like I'm really into something here, I want to do this, and it's you charge ahead, you don't think things through. They think you're really rash, okay, reckless, okay, and you don't think about the consequences, and you're always causing drama. You know, like I said, with the two of cups, it is a commitment here. And this person's feeling that with the way you are, your habits, it's like you're causing them so much stress here and worry. I feel like this energy feels like, well, what's group one gonna do next? You know, what do I need to prepare myself for next? You know, because we do have the Ace of Cups here. This is love, marriage and commitment here. This is not very nice. Whoever this is, feels like that you've got that you, when they got with you, okay, you know, this could be a friend, it doesn't really matter, okay, but when they met you, they felt like you hid a side of yourself from them, okay, like you put on an act, hence the people pleaser. You know, you do things to please people, and maybe it's to cover up something about, you know, the dark side of you. You know, we've all got that dark shadow side, okay, that your shadow self, we've all got that. So don't sit there feeling offended right now, because even I have a shadow side, okay, that, you know, we all have demons that we don't really want to show people, okay. So this energy is literally saying that they feel like they were duped, okay, they feel like that you hid this from them, that really there is something mentally wrong with you, group one. And I'm just a tarot reader, okay? This I feel like this energy is an a-hole, okay? I feel this energy is projecting. Because what I'm actually getting from your energy, group one, that you are such a kind soul, okay? And I feel like you guys do get distracted, okay, but you know, sometimes that can be endearing, sometimes it can be annoying, because my husband's like that. Honestly, he goes to do something, the weekend lawnmower was broken, but he needed to fix the outlet pipe in our house, because it's the outlet pipe for the toilets which is more important, okay, that was leaking. So it's like, what is more important? And it's so frustrating, because he's all over the place, you know, and it's not out of it's not you guys doing it out of spite, it's just that is who you are, and you like to help people as well, and it doesn't make you a people pleaser, it just means that you're a good soul. And this person's being very judgy right now, okay? You may have wondered whether they do think this about you, they may have even said things sometimes, because with the Knight of Swords, this is somebody that can be saying, you know, can be quite aggressive at times, verbally abusive as well, you know, like putting you down and making you feel crap about yourself. And this is what I'm getting. So it's like they feel like you've got something wrong with your mind, okay, that something's not quite right about you. And it's like I'm seeing here, they just want, you know, that this energy saying I chose group one, but I feel like they're feeling like it's not, that you're not really balanced, okay? That you're not, it's like your time is taken elsewhere. I mean, some of you could be caregivers, okay? You know, you may help family that are in need, you know. There is something very caring about your energy, group one. And for this person to feel so crappy. And do you know what I'm picking up from this energy? It's about attention. It's about that they're not feeling wanted. They feel neglected. Okay, and that is just selfish. I mean, maybe there is times that, you know, maybe you have put other people first, but, you know, this energy needs to be a bit more understanding. So we do have Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, very strong air sign in this reading, Virgo and Taurus, okay? Let me find out why, you know, this is mainly so honing, I cannot talk. This is literally picking at the your habits, okay? So I want to look at why the people pleaser. So why is this person, this energy, giving group one the side eye for being a people pleaser? Thank you. King of Cups. Mm-hmm. Tell me why. Here's Spirit. So we have the Eight of Wands in reverse, we have the Five of Pentacles in reverse, and we have the Four of Pentacles in reverse, okay? And we do have Temperance. Alright, bear with me, guys. You know what it is, okay? This people pleaser, like I said, it's like you're so loving and kind, okay? With the King of Cups, you're so caring, very sympathetic to people's, you know, plights and things like that. So this is what I already said about you guys. So it's like you want to help, you want to do good for other people. But, you know, maybe you guys do more volunteer work. So what this energy feels like, because you're a people pleaser, finances and you know, the finances, home life and things like that have been a struggle, okay? And they feel like that, you know, you've got no ambition. This is not something that you should be doing. And this is where this energy comes in as being a judgy, can't swear. Well, she could, because seriously. Yeah. So they don't like the fact that you want to please other people. It's like this energy is saying, well, you know, you should be pleasing me. It's like they feel like that things are just moving so slowly. It's just like things are just not moving forward with both of you here because of the way you are. You know, this energy is saying that they're struggling financially, and they want to improve this. But Spirit is saying that finances will start improving here with the Five of Pentacles in reverse. They want you to let go of people. They, you know, with the Four of Pentacles, they want you to let go. This could be even some of you, okay? This could be the person with the King of Cups, an elderly gentleman. I'm picking up an elderly masculine here that you may care for, have to look after, okay? Like a father, grandparent, okay? I am picking this up, and whoever this is that you're involved with doesn't have any understanding here. They've got no compassion. And they want you to let go of this. They don't want you constantly giving to somebody else here. And it could be that maybe you and your partner are financially supporting this King of Cups as well, okay? So, you know, that's taking a strain on the finances. So, tell me about this Four of Pentacles in reverse. Why does this person energy want group one to let go? Pentacles, please, Spirit. Knight of Cups. Yeah, because they want you to be giving to them. They want you to show them attention, affection, love. They're feeling rejected. Yeah. Oh, what did I just... I love it when my cards just say, look, all right, I'm giving myself a bit of a ego boost still. Someone's got to bloody do it, because no one else will. I just said this person's feeling rejected and unloved, and as I went like that, I saw the Five of Cups, okay? This is somebody feeling very unloved and rejected, okay? If they're feeling abandoned, so maybe you're not noticing, okay, that this person, maybe they're not communicating this to you, they're keeping it from you. They want to go out and they want to do, you know, they want to do more things with you. They want to go out on dates, date nights, and, you know, maybe Netflix and chill and that kind of thing, you know, but they're feeling unwanted. Okay. So there is more to this energy here, but to judge your partner the way this person's judging you is really like disrespectful. It's not nice. It really isn't nice. You know, and they're trying to be strong about this, okay? They're trying to avoid confrontation and arguments, but they want a new beginning. Thank God this person sent them a new... These just came the other day. I mean, I've just noticed that one. And these weren't cheap, because I get my cards from abroad. Sorry, I've got really distracted because this has peed me off as well. So quite a lot of the cards were damaged, but I'm using it because she's sending me a new set, bless her. But it's not the point. That one's mullered. So yeah, this energy wants a fresh beginning here, a new start. Maybe start again. But I don't feel like this energy really communicates this to you. I feel like they lash out at you instead of actually saying, look, I feel like this, I feel like that, you know? Whew. Okay. So let me get... I'm going to get the person's personality here. So tell me what this energy's personality is like for group one, please, Spirit. Actually, no, it's that way. So we've got visionary, risk taker, enjoy being alone, to hone their craft, are comfortable with crowds and expressing ideas. People admire their bold and confident attitude. So this is describing the person that's come through here. Okay, let's get a few more. Okay, you wanted to come out. Challenger. Revolutionary, fights the status quo, inspires leader, joins causes, questions, bold, takes the road, less traveled, defends. And I feel like, because you see, I'm picking up opposites attract here, because this person's quite a strong energy, okay, and you are someone who is very, I feel like you're not placid, like, just, why am I hearing soft spoken? Like, I'm quite, like, when I talk, I'm quite, I don't know, how do you say it? Quite forward and quite, you know, but you guys are the opposite, okay? I feel like you don't speak up for yourselves. I feel like you keep quiet. And then people judge you as being a people pleaser, but you're not. It's like you don't like confrontation. There's nothing wrong with that. Okay, this one came out backwards. So we've got, I don't even know what that says. Oedipal child. Jealousy and resentment. Insecure and competitive. Anxious. Lacks awareness and struggles with ego. This is what I said right at the beginning. Unhealthy relations towards same-sex parent. So this energy, I did say, was very jealous of you. And I feel like because you've got that energy group one where people, I feel like that you are a type of people that, like, you know, there's this saying here. I don't know why that just came to my head. And there is a saying, it's a compliment though, by the way. Fly to shit. Okay. So, you know, flies are drawn to crap. It's like you have this pull with people. And I feel like this energy here, because they're so, they've got such a big ego and they're very brash and what have you. It's like people are a bit put off by them, whereas you're the type of person that people like to be around because there's this energy about you that's really sweet and caring. Okay, you're good people. So, you know, I said about jealousy and resentment. They're very insecure, which I said because they feel like you're neglecting them. Anxious, which I said about the Ten of Wands as well. Lacks awareness. Struggles with ego. Unhealthy relations. So they could end up clashing with their same-sex parent as well, okay? It could even be that's a parent that you're actually looking after, which is their parent. You're doing them a favour, you know? Take what resonates, okay? So let's see what else this energy wants to say. Shock. Unexpected shock to the system. Okay. So it could be that maybe some of you lot are starting to stick up for yourselves. And it also could be just a shock that they, you know, like I said, when you got with them, they didn't really notice that this character flaw, as they like to call it, which it's not. And maybe they just thought, oh, okay. Mourning. Suffering a loss. Give yourself time before proceeding. So some of you may have actually ended things with this energy here, okay? Maybe it got to the point that you were fed up with the verbal abuse by this person. Maybe you have suffered a loss of a loved one here, or they have, but I feel like this is more of a message to you guys, okay? Give yourself time. Trigger. You are being triggered. Take time to heal. So this, I feel like this energy does trigger you guys, okay? But like I said, you're not confrontational. It's like you don't really like people that attack you in, you know what I mean, verbally attack you. You don't like arguments. You don't like confrontation. You don't like people being petty and jealous. Love, admiration, adoration, honeymoon phase. So, you know, this energy did want a new beginning, okay? Maybe you guys can get to back to this honeymoon stage in your relationship. Right, I want to get you some little messages here for a bit of a boost, okay? So, let's have a look. So, for group one, so this is for you guys, okay? Two. So we have, let's turn them around, we have hope and we have complementary, okay? So let's have a look at hope. It says, this earth word reflects the energy of unconditional love that brings positive change to your life's path. And I feel like this is your life path as well, okay? Is that you have this positive energy, okay? It creates an optimistic state of mind that creates expectation of positive outcomes, helping this hope energy reflect your thoughts for a better future. That positive future is waiting for all of you, but you reflect heavy energies of self-doubt and thinking yourself unworthy of this positive change in your human's life. And exactly, and if you've got people like this that attack you, your character constantly, you know, you start to believe that and you start to doubt yourself as a person. Change in your human's life. Trust you can manifest positive change in your lives. Believe in yourselves. Hope and dream of the best life you could possibly have on earth. We know you can live wonderful lives with compassion, kindness and love, with abundance of positive energy to thrive. And that is exactly what I've been trying to say, that you guys are. Sit down today and imagine your life, imagine the life you would love to lead and how you can improve yourself and others to achieve this wonderful life you did so deserve. Okay? So Spirit is saying you've got hope for the future. If this is not making you happy, then you don't have to stay. If you want to stay and make it work, there is a new beginning here and there is love right here, okay? To fix things. Then we have complementary. is a way of being for many celestial species, allowing their admiration for all in many forms of existence to be expressed. If from the heart it is true, it is a true expression from your love of life and others. Exactly. We notice many humans on your earth do not give compliments or like to receive them. The negative jealousy energy prevents you expressing what you admire. Wow, you know, you can't make this up, group one. It's literally what I was saying. It's like you I'm not good at explaining things. I confuse myself. But this is basically what I was saying. There's something, you're a giver, okay? There's a brilliant, beautiful energy surrounding you guys. And then you've got these dark energies that try to knock that down, okay? So, you know, and jealousy, okay? So the negative jealousy energy prevents you expressing what you admire of all living things, or you do not feel worthy to receive them from others that want to praise you. It is time to shift into the new earth energy being created by us on earth. Reset your thought patterns to give praise and admiration to others that achieve beauty and their goals in life. You need to accept compliments from others and learn to hear the celestial voices of admiration for all of humanity. This is coming from your, you know, starseed family, okay? This card right here. So listen to that, group one, okay? Start accepting compliments. Start, you know, if people want to give you gratitude for helping people, you take it and you run with that. So I also want to get you a little message from this deck as well. I'm just going to bang it because I haven't used them yet. So for group one, please, spirit. Oh, calm down. Sorry, I do apologize. Right, we've got this one, turn it over. Getting nowhere. You may need to adjust the lens of your life, change your mindset, and then change your lifestyle. You can still turn things around. Yep. Because maybe you're not getting anywhere with this person that's involved in your life. You know, maybe they just keep putting you down and not giving you the encouragement to be who you are. I mean, who would actually try and tell someone that they're an a-hole for helping others and wanting to give to others? Doesn't make sense to me. You know, but dark energy likes light energy, you know, and they feed off of that. I don't know why I'm getting this person's like an energy vampire, okay? Let's get one more. Allow your higher good. Don't be upset because things didn't work out the way your ego planned. Have faith that what is in your hindsight, in your highest good will come. Okay? So, you know, if it doesn't work out with whoever this is, you know, things are failing and you feel like I really do need to move on. I'm going to get one more, guys, for you because you're special. Let's get one more. You know, yeah, you're here to do something, group one. You really are. Guided lessons. Your higher self is guiding you to make mistakes so you can learn important lessons. Exactly. I feel like Earth is our school, honestly. I really do. Silence the noise. Noise creates illusions and problems out of nothing. Go deeper into your heart so you may find the truth. Exactly. Silence this energy here. Silence people around you. Go within. It is like the hermit, and we do have the hermit there. Okay, group one. And think about it properly, okay? Don't ever doubt yourself for being a bloody good person. So let's get a question for you guys. So think of your question or ask it out loud and let's see what spirit says. So we've got two here. It could be, what did you say? Oh, don't start this again. So, okay, rephrase it in a different way, guys, because sometimes spirit will do this when they don't quite understand, okay? So Let's do that again. So there is a possibility here. I'm gonna give it a good shuffle. No. Okay. So spirit saying no. So group one. If you like this reading, please hit like, it really helps my channel, guys. And if you're new here, please consider subscribing, staying, love to have you. And you take care, guys. Much love. Hey, group two. So if you chose this eye card, and I haven't looked at anybody's thingy, group one was really, really good reading, actually. So let's have a look at yours. So we have the side eye you are getting is this person feels like you are a beggar, a mooch, an opportunist, and a user. Wow. Okay. So let's find out why and who. Okay. These cards can be so harsh sometimes, honestly. So tell me, please, spirit, for group two, why does this energy give group two the side eye? Why do they feel like group two is a beggar and a mooch and an opportunist and a user? Wow. So why is group two getting the side eye? Whoever you're dealing with is very stubborn. Okay, this energy is stubborn. This energy is like, it's my way or the highway, okay? They think they're always right as well. They shove their opinions onto you, you know? And this person's always got an opinion. But don't forget, side eye is usually when someone don't really tell you what they're thinking. Yeah, look at these cards. This energy doesn't want to come through. Come on. Tell me why this person is giving group two the side eye. Wow. And I refuse to pick the cards out. Like I've said many a times, I like my cards when I'm doing readings for other people to fly out, because then I know it's your energy or the energy that's come through. And wow. Oh, this energy is strong. This is a strong person, okay? This a strong energy. This is someone, when they enter a room, their presence takes over. Oh, here we go, finally. Two of Wands, Seven of Cups. Tell me a bit more, please, spirit. Why is this energy giving group two the side eye? Eight of Cups, Justice, the Sun, the Chariot, and the High Priestess. Okay, group two. Straight away, this energy gives you the side eye, okay? Because you guys are very spiritual, okay? You're into you know, tarot and the occult, okay? Which obviously you are, because you're here, okay? And this person thinks you're delusional. They're not a believer. They are really not a believer, okay? And I feel like sometimes, you know, you may have tried to speak to this person about your beliefs, and they cut it down. It's like, don't talk nonsense. You know, which is really, really sad that this person hasn't got a spiritual bone in their body. See, this beggar and mooch, this energy feels like that things come to you too easily, okay? So it could be maybe, you know, your partner spoils you. You know, maybe some of you recently have had a car bought for you, okay? Or, you know, a gift given to you. And this energy is like, well, you don't deserve that. And you know what is so funny doing this reading with Justice? It's like this person's judging you, literally judging you on who you are. They've already made up their mind about you, Group Two, and it's like, yeah, I'm judging you for who you are. You guys have a healing energy, okay? There's something very pure about you guys. You know, you're very abundant as well. You're very successful, but this energy feels like that you haven't earned this yourself. It's been given to you. And this energy is also saying that basically you are a type of person to use people with the Eight of Cups here. It's like you get what you want and then off I go. They feel like that you are a type of person that will just cut someone out of their life automatically, you know, like after you've got everything out of a partner or whoever, okay? And then you'll just walk away and cut them off. They feel like that you have commitment issues here, you know, they're side-eyeing you because you get with a partner and then maybe after a few months you walk away, you leave it, you know, you leave them there. So it's like I said, you use this person for what they've got, you get what you want, and then you're off again. Okay, they feel like, you know, the side eye is also that they feel like that you, the path you're on is destructive, that you're also someone who sleeps around. Okay. And now that's not, now obviously it's not true, you know. And even if it is, so what? Who are they to judge? So we do have Libra, Cancer, and Leo. You know, and these cards literally clarify the beggar and the mooch, and an opportunity, and an opportunist, and a user. So. Who is this person? Who is this energy spirit, please, to Group Two? Who are they? It's giving them the side eye. Who are they, please, spirit? Who is this person to Group Two? Jesus. Money. Okay, I'm going to have to shove them up there, guys, because these cards are really big. Even though my table's big, I still run out of bloody room. So we do have the Five of Pentacles. Sorry. Well, that would explain the bloody... it's not even projection, actually. This explains, literally, the jealousy that is coming from this person towards you, because you've got everything going for yourself. Things do fall at your feet, okay? You guys are very lucky. Nothing wrong with that. You're blessed with the sun. It's like the universe smiles upon you, and this is where the jealousy is coming in here, because this person, it doesn't do... They're always financially struggling, okay? They may end up moaning to you about finances and can't make ends meet and my partner don't love me and da-da-da-da-da. And it's like... Yeah, and I feel like Group Two, you've tried to maybe give this person some advice. You know, like I said, like you guys are very spiritual, okay? Maybe you've tried to guide them the spiritual, you know, the spiritual path. And this person, this is when they knock you down and like they're like, don't be stupid. Okay, so we have the King of Cups. We have the can't even bloody say that. That is Temperance anyway. Yeah, that's Temperance. The Ten of Pentacles. Yeah, look. Three of Cups. Princess of Pentacles and the Three of Pentacles. Someone you work with. Thank you, Spirit, for clarifying my question. It's somebody you work with, okay? This is somebody that might even be your boss. Okay, or you work under them. Okay, so I feel like, you know, I don't know why I'm hearing part-time work as well. So maybe some of you don't work full-time, but, you know, because you just do it because you don't, you know, because you want to work, but you don't really need to work. This is someone that is the King of Cups, someone that is, can be very emotionally immature and cold towards you as well, and very uncaring, and they may have a personality of being very moody, okay? It's like this energy feels like they've got their shite together, but they really don't. They really don't. And this energy really hates the fact that the side eye that's coming here is that you're in alignment with yourself. Your life is all balanced, you know. This is either a friend. We do have Three of Pentacles, Three of Cups. Or it's a friend from work, okay? Maybe you felt like they were your friend. You know, maybe you've had an inkling that this person gives you the side eye. But this energy doesn't like you, group two. And the reason in it is because of the Ten of Pentacles. You guys are abundant, okay? You're financially set here. You may even come from wealth, you know, generational wealth, okay? Nothing wrong with that. But it may be that this energy feels like you're going after people with generational wealth, and using people to gain, you know, some kind of reward for it, like I said at the beginning. So like I said, there's so many of you, take what resonates here. You know, and then we do have the Page of Pentacles, which is work. This is a strong work situation right here. Maybe some of you guys got promoted above this person as well, and this is where the resentment comes from. You know, maybe they feel like you don't deserve it. Let me dig into more of this. Tell me about this Three of Pentacles, please. You know, you're solid. You're okay. So we do have Sagittarius as well, guys. And Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. Tell me about this Three of Pentacles. Yeah, this could be a business partner or working situation here, okay? Because this can mean contracts and working with other people as well, the Lovers. Tell me about this Three of Pentacles and the Tower. The Moon and the Four of Pentacles. Yeah, this energy, okay, the World. There's a major arcana right here. This is like someone that feels like feels like that you need to learn a lesson, but that's not up to them whether they need to judge you and whether you deserve to have a lesson or whatever. This energy is an idiot, sorry. So we do have Aquarius, we do have Pisces, okay? So I clarified the Three of Pentacles. This is somebody that you work with. Bear with me. This energy thinks you're a disgrace, you know, and they want to, I know this sounds really drastic, okay, but they want to ruin you, they want to end you, or they want you gone from the work environment here with the World, with the Three of Pentacles, with Tower here as well. Their feelings for you, like their resentment for you, runs so deep. and it's hidden from you. So some of you guys may even not even know about this, but maybe your intuition with the moon here has been telling you that, you know, you've had a feeling, but you're not quite sure whether this person likes you or not. Because I feel like sometimes when you go out as a crowd, like maybe you go for drinks after work or something, and then what happens is this person's all nicey-nicey to your face, but then you then get that vibe, you know, because if you guys are spiritual and you go with your gut is telling you that something is not quite right about this person. So this person is like two-faced. It's like they're showing you like a fake side to them, but really what is hidden from them is that they really do not like you. They don't like the fact that you, when you walk in a room, group two, is you light up the room, okay? There's, you have star quality about you, okay? You get noticed, things happen for you. Like I said, it's like you're blessed. It's like things just fall at your feet, and it's like it's nothing. You're just blessed. And they would like you to leave this work environment. They don't want you there. Yeah, they don't want you there. This person is holding on to so much resentment because of this star quality that we've got right here for you, you know? So this is the energy that's giving you the side eye right here, group two. It's somebody from work that really does not like you. They don't like your energy. I'm really surprised the devil didn't come out, actually, because this is quite dark energy, really. It's like somebody that is very dark, very judgmental. And you get a lot of attention, you know, when you go out and you socialize, and I feel like this person doesn't really get much attention, you know, because they're not the star. But that's not your fault at all. So let's get the personality of this person. So tell me about the personality for group two of this energy here, please, spirit. What is their personality like? So we do have visionary. So this is a risk taker, enjoy being alone, to hone their craft, comfortable with crowds and expressing ideas. People admire their bold and confident attitude. And that is what I said right at the beginning. This person is like someone that takes charge and gets noticed in that sense. I feel like for you guys, you're very, very good looking, okay? Very attractive people. And this is where the jealousy is here. The only thing that this person's got going for them is their career, is their boldness. But I feel like sometimes they can be quite intimidating, and it's like, you know, maybe people just don't like that. And, you know, in visionary is, you know, if you look, it's someone that works high up as well, you know, that has these ideas. It's this one again. Oedipal child. Jealousy and resentment. There you go. Insecure and competitive. Anxious, lacks awareness and struggles with ego. Unhealthy relations towards the same-sex parents. Maybe they've got mummy and daddy issues. Let's get a bit more. Okay, this person is a networker, social butterfly, chats up one person after another, spreads and shares ideas and brings change, exchanges and saves business cards for future. So this person is a networker, okay? You guys could work with computers, or this person works with computers. Let me get one more. I do strongly do feel this is someone from work. Office politics, hey? And we have child, naivety, ignorance, over-dependence, tantrums, and I said they were childish, stubbornness, sulkiness, said that, moodiness, said that, unprepared, draining, overwhelmed. And you know what? I don't know whether I said it, but when I was doing this reading, maybe I did say it, I don't know, but I've heard this person is draining. You know, they drain you with their moaning, and then their it's like it's 1 minute you don't know who you, 1 minute they're this way and then the next way they're this way, and it's like it's so draining, you know. So I feel like you try to avoid this person as much as you can. Maybe you hide in the loo at work. I shouldn't say that. I would if I saw this person come in. Honestly, I'm gonna lock myself in the toilet, tell them I've got the craps, you know. I'll be a while. Anyway, let's see who this energy is. So, the Sun. Natural leaders, strong-willed, focused, inventive, responsible, and determined. So, yeah, these are... So, this could be a strong Leo energy that you're working for. These are natural-born leaders, you know. But I did say that this energy is someone that works above you, okay? Friend, there you go. Kind and respectful to you, laughs with you, comfort when you cry. But, you know, I'm looking at this in the negative aspect, and it did come out like this. This is not your friend. So basically, it's saying kind and respectful, but they're not, okay? But I feel like they do it in such a clever way that they disrespect you in, you know, maybe joking. And there's that saying, many a true word said in jest, okay? Laughs with you, laughs at you, guys, and comforts you when you cry. Nah, they get satisfaction at seeing your tears and your pain. So this person is local to you. This one is living in the same area, city or country with you. This could be a Taurus energy, okay? I'm not reading the top part. Can be stubborn or obstinate at times as well, okay? So I'm going to get some messages for you guys now. These are like little boosty messages before I close your reading. So for group... two, please, Spirit. What message do you have for group two? My eye is burning. Ugh. Just bloody see. So we've got fulfillment. I absolutely love these cards, the colours. Anyway, fulfillment is achieved by your desires that you seek to fulfill your human needs. A concept of fulfillment in a human mind is a self-satisfying energy that is seeked. A journey that some of you never fulfill, as you do not understand this process in your three-dimensional reality. Love, grace, compassion and kindness is the positive energies you need to fulfill your earthly needs. Then allow life to fall into place in a natural flow without seeking any desires. What you need will find you when the energy and the time is right. Look at what you have achieved so far. The selfless acts of the heart, loving another such as a pet or a fellow human. Please dream and seek your desires in the name of love and let them flow to you naturally through your heart space. But I feel like your heart space is open, group two, and I feel like you do overlook a lot of the things that this energy does here, okay? And you're trying to be compassionate. Maybe you're trying, you know, I'm like that as well. When you know someone is just being an a-hole, then you try and be compassionate towards that person because you don't really want to hurt their feelings. And I feel like that's you guys. So, you know, Spirit's saying, keep doing that. Sometimes we want to lash out. You know, there may be a day that you may end up lashing out, but Spirit doesn't want you to do that. So let's get a couple of more messages for you from Spirit. So for group two, please, Spirit, what message do you have? Stand your ground. Hold your own power and never give it away. Not everyone is there to support you exactly. Do not let this person take that star quality away from you, okay, group two? Never let anyone take that that power away from you. And I don't feel like you are, though. I feel like you guys are just as wise as this, whatever they are. Liberate yourself. You don't have to carry your burdens alone. Have the courage to ask and accept help. So maybe this person, maybe you might be struggling at work. You're too fearful to go and speak to this person because maybe, you know, they end up lashing out at you or verbally putting you down, okay? Maybe you just need to speak to someone about this. Maybe you started noticing it and you just need to get it off your chest. This is a beautiful card. In the making, you're entering a new reality, opening up to new levels of you and where your best self exists. It's your time to shine, so don't hold back anything back. Exactly. Star. The star energy. There you go. It's your time to shine. Don't let anybody dim that light. So think of a question or ask a question and let's see what Spirit says, okay? For group two, please, Spirit. Ask me closer to the time. Well, they can't do that, Spirit. And then we've got not ever. Okay. Let me do that again. You know, some of you can take that not ever, but let's do that again. Spirit's been a bit funny with these cards today. Group one was the same. Surely not. So not ever and surely not. Spirit is very, very strong in saying not. Okay. So group two, this is your reading. If you like this reading, please hit like. It really, really helps the channel. And if you're new here, please consider subscribing. I would love to have you. And you take care, guys. Much love. Hey, group three. So if you chose this I card, let's have a look why this energy is giving you the side eye. So I smile in your face and talk shite behind your back. So this energy gives you the side eye because they think you're two-faced, okay, and that you're a gossip, okay. Yeah, so there we go, lovely. So let's have a look. So Spirit, tell me for group three, why does this energy give group three the side eye? Why do they feel like group three smiles in people's faces and talks crap behind their back? Five of Wands in reverse. The Hermit. The Magician. Yeah, look, they feel like you're two-faced. It's exactly what I just said. They feel like you you gossip behind people's back here with a Hermit, okay? It's like you hear something and then you rush off and you go and gossip. With the Five of Wands, okay, upright, this is competition. So this could be someone that you may have been in competition with, may have felt like you were competition. You know, maybe you two, I don't know, or did something similar and they felt like you were a threat, okay? So I feel like you had an argument with this person, but that has come to an end, but they still view you. Maybe you sorted it out, okay, in private with one another. But they still see you as this two-faced manipulator right here and a gossip. You know, the Eight of Wands is the energy, meaning you communicate to other people, you talk about other people's problems, or, you know, maybe you got told something and you went and spoke about this, okay? So it's like you're always messaging someone or phoning someone to give them the update, you know, or the gossip. So tell me about this Magician and Eight of Wands. So this energy, I do feel like you had a falling out with them, okay? It got to that stage where, like, you both ended up, like, really, like, going at each other. Okay, we've got the Chariot. So we do have Virgo and Cancer here. Yeah, see, this energy saying that as soon as you find out something or someone's got an idea, you rush off to gossip about this. And I can't say shite constantly, so I'm saying gossip, okay? Tell me more, why is this energy giving group three the side eye? Please, Spirit. Mm-hmm. Because apparently they feel like you go and talk people's truths. You know, you have people that open up to you, they tell you private things about themselves, and you go and talk about this to other people. Okay, you reveal people's secrets when you shouldn't, or you steal other people's ideas. So this could be somebody that you work with, okay? So tell me about this Ace of Swords. Prince of Wands. That's the Knight of Wands. Tell me about... It's like... Yeah, look at this. You know, this is not true, okay? So don't take offense. But this energy, like I said, about you going and running off and telling people about other people's business, and being this two-faced, the magician, the energy is saying that you, you know, the Knight of Wands, the card is he rushes off. And then, like, comes flying back, you know. So, an in and out energy, very reckless at times, okay. But this is what I'm getting. It's like I'm just seeing you rushing off to talk about someone's truth or gossip about something, and then you come back for more information. So, the Seven of Swords is this energy is saying that you are sneaky, you're two-faced, okay. You lie, you steal, you cheat, It's just that they look at you side-eyed because they just feel like you are just a sneaky, sneaky person, okay? So we do have Leo, Aries, Sagittarius here. Tell me about the Seven of Swords. Why the Seven of Swords spirit? Okay. So we do have the Princess of Swords, which is the Page of Swords in reverse, Eight of Swords in reverse, Four of Wands in reverse, Queen of Cups in reverse, wow, the Star in reverse, the Four of Cups in reverse, and the Queen of Swords in the reverse. This energy really, really thinks so. Look at, I'll say this in a minute. So, you know, they see you like you're shite on the end of their shoe. They feel like you are the hugest backstabber going group three, okay? That you are willing to stab anybody in the back. Whew. So, I'm clarified the Seven of Swords. Why do they think you're sneaky? Why do they think you're two-faced, you know? And this energy is saying with the Page of Swords that you cause an injustice in someone's life, okay? Maybe you did slip up group three, maybe you did tell someone, then this person twisted it. You know what people are like, Jesus, they're just straining. You know, and twisted the truth, and maybe, I don't know why I'm hearing that you guys wasn't the one that actually let the cat out of the bag, okay? You wasn't the one that went and told someone's secret or whatever it was. It's like, you know, the playground right here, right now. So they feel like you did something really bad to someone here, and you're not admitting to this energy here. I mean, who the bloody hell do you think you are? If they're not you're not admitting to this person the truth. They want the truth from you. Okay, this could be someone that may actually be this energy here. Maybe they told you something, but then they told someone else, and they're blaming you for that, okay? So because you're not speaking the truth, they feel like you are a sneak. You know, a sneak. And this energy is so resentful towards you, side-eyeing you, because they feel like you had a lucky escape. It's like you didn't get the backlash for this. You didn't get the you received no consequences. Wow, this energy really hates you, group three. Who the bloody hell is this? I'm not going to find out. Oh. Oh. Okay. Some kind of gossip, some kind of gossip was going on here that may have caused a celebration, like a party or a wedding or an engagement. Something was cancelled because of this gossip. And yeah, that's why the resentment is here. Something got cancelled. And they're saying that you are such an unhappy person that you need to make other people unhappy. And with the Queen of Cups, this person's giving you the side eye. They're actually saying that you're very insecure and weak-minded, you're very needy, you can be very smothering, you can be spiteful, you can be sulky. I can go on and on and on. Oof. It's like this energy is so bitter. That's the only word I can think of it. Bitter is because, you know, even when the star is reversed, it's still very positive, okay? Because it's still, your wishes are still coming true. Things are happening for you, okay? You know, things are going good for you here, and this energy here, they wanted you to feel stuck. They wanted you to feel something here, maybe buy it from other people, but it didn't work. It's like you've moved on from this, okay? And it's like they're still stuck in the past here. Whereas you're moving on and you're loving life, okay? You're missing your best life here. And I feel like this energy here is the Queen of Swords right here, because she's right at the end right here, okay? And the Queen of Swords is somebody that is very, very bitter and very malicious, can be very cruel. This person lacks empathy, they're very critical of others. I mean, maybe the side eye is coming from, maybe the event that was cancelled was something to do, you know, was to do with you, group three. Maybe something in, like, was you were wanting to celebrate something. Something was meant to happen for you. You know, take this if it resonates with you, okay? And it got cancelled, and this energy's thinking to themselves, you know, well, you deserved it, really. Because I was going to ask the next question of who is this to you? So tell me more about this Queen of Swords in reverse. So we do have Leo, Aries, Sagittarius, very strong air sign, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, and we do have Aquarius right here, and Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. Okay, tell me about this Queen of Swords in reverse for group three, please. Page of Swords. Yeah, this is someone that can be really reckless with their words, okay? Very abrupt and can be quite aggressive. This energy is like a bully energy. They just like to bully people. Tell me more about this Queen of Swords. Who is this energy to group three, please? The Hangman. Someone that's stuck in the past, someone that can't let go of the past here. So we've got Sagittarius as well. Tell me why the Hangman and Temperance, please, Spirit. Thank you. Nine of Swords, the Hierophant. So this could even be a parent of yours, okay? Like a sibling or something like that, okay? This energy could be married, all right? Or very religious, you know? They like their religion, and they have morals, or they think they have morals, but they don't. Okay, that's just an act. And this energy suffers with anxiety as well. They may not sleep very well. I feel like this person may suffer with depression. They may be a recovering addict. Okay, so this is what I'm trying to see who this energy is. Tell me about temperance. Why is temperance here? This is inner peace, okay? This is balance. This is someone who has a lot of self-control. And that would explain the Queen of Swords, because she does have a lot of control, okay? Self-control. She's very clever, but very evil in reverse. Tell me about the Temperance here, please, Spirit. The Tower. And the Knight of Pentacles. You know what? That on the outside of the world, they show to the world, is that they are this peace, tranquil person. You know, I'm very balanced, I'm in harmony with myself, but no, inside themselves, they are the Tower. They are full of destruction. They're full of destructive thoughts. They like to leave a mass destruction in their wake, okay? They don't care. That is what they're actually hiding. This is what they're showing to the world, because, you know, I feel like this person may go to church, okay? Nothing wrong with that. Not saying anything that's wrong with that, but they show this side of themselves to the churchgoers and things like that, or their religious background that they've got, that I am the Temperance, you know, this healing angel energy. But no, you're not. This energy has been hiding the truth from a lot of people, and I feel like Group 3, you've seen this anyway, which is just pure destruction. They're like chaotic. Their energy is very chaotic. So group three, I don't know if I said group one there, so I do apologise if I did. So group three, this energy here, strong feminine energy here, okay, but you can swap it around, and it's literally clarified that card. It's something that you went and communicated with someone, and it caused problems for other people, but you keep doing this, you know, you keep gossiping about other people behind their back, and it's like you're a two-faced square, you know, you smile in their face, and it's like, but really I'm chatting crap about you. But this is not you, guys, okay? This is how this energy side-eyes you, thinking that this is what you're like. If I was you, if you're still in this person's life, or they're in your life, should I say, stay as far away. My voice went to go there as well, as I went to say that. Stay as far as away as you possibly can from this energy, okay? Because it's quite dark. Okay. And as I said that, there was that noise out there. So let's look at the personality type of this energy here. So tell us more about the personality. So we have visionary, overthinking, struggles with details, loses motivation when following rules, grand ideas with no follow through or action. Okay. Then we have crime fighter, control freak, twisted sense of humor, overworked, chaotic lifestyle, isolation, untrusting. That's what I just said. It's like, I can't say that word. You know when there's some words that you really, really cannot say, and this is one of them, and how embarrassing, but never mind. So I don't know whether you can see it on camera, guys. It's that word there. Okay, so that is the Tower. So basically, crappy way of thinking about yourself. So suspicious and lonely. And this is literally, that has literally clarified what I've just said here. This person is so paranoid, okay? So suspicious of everyone. So maybe it was something that came out about this energy, okay? And they blamed you, and you're not speaking the truth that it was you, even though it wasn't you. Do you get me? It's like playground crap. So yeah. I yeah, I do feel like this energy is very lonely. That's not your problem. I'm not surprised, really, to be honest. Oh, there's quite a few that come out there. They obviously came out for a reason. Oh my god. Okay. Wow. Let's have a look. So we have a critic. Naysayer, skeptical, for God's sake, forcefully expresses their position, not open-minded, opinionated, critical, negative, argue for the sake of argument. Anarchist, violent, obsessed, single-mindedness, rowdy, unwielding, discontented, angry, fear and confusion, nihilistic, ego-driven. Okay. Achiever. Full of themselves, cutthroat, alienates, choosing outside gratification, using achievements to demonstrate worth. So they could be very boastful, you know, I've got this, I've got that, I've done this, and I'm in this position, you know, that kind of person. Guru, abuse of power, huge temptation to the ego, predator as a channel of the divine, cannot deal with other people's projections. So, so this could be somebody like who is attracted to light beings, okay, like you guys are light beings, okay. So they, it's like an energy vampire. They're sucking people like you, sucking your energy, okay, because there's something very light and beautiful about you, okay. I did say you were the star. And they need people like this because it's like it's feeding that dark energy. So let's get a message for you. Actually, no, hang on. Let's get a bit more about this energy here. Let's more about who this energy is for group three. Egotistical, depressed, and materialistic. Yeah, I don't feel like this person's got much going on in their life. It's not your fault, you know. Self-pity, indecisive, overly emotional, self-confident, codependent. Wow, these are just clarifying these cards here as well. Opposite sex, contrasting energies, alternative viewpoints, secret admirer, getting preference. So this could be an opposite sex, but, you know, can be same sex, doesn't matter. Jupiter, artistic, talented, social, optimistic and generous, but I'm seeing this negatively because this is a very negative energy, okay? So then they're not really artistic. Maybe they are talented in their work, okay? But then they're not generous. This is a stranger to you, feeling free to share new energy, don't judge you, start of a relationship. So maybe they didn't judge you at the beginning, okay? Maybe this person, you know, obviously everybody's a stranger when we first meet someone, but this energy changed over time and they're slim, okay? So let's get a personal message for you guys from Spirit, a little boost for you. For group three, please, Spirit, what message do you have for group three? Spirit is saying touch, okay. Every day in your human life you have touched someone's heart and soul. From the day you were born, giving your unconditional love to another, a hug, or by guiding another into the light of hope. Exactly, light beings. You guys are light beings, and you've got this beautiful light energy, and you will attract so many energies like this in your lifetime, okay. Talking from experience. If you are reading this and do not feel you have achieved this in your life, it is time to reset your life's journey on earth. First of all, write down all those people in your life you have helped through compassion and kindness. Don't feel humble, as this is your true path to be like this. If the list is long, then you are well on the way to creating the spiritual energy of light and love you are here to bring to earth. If your list is short, then you really need to reevaluate your life, your behaviour, and those that surround you. Okay, there's a big message there. You are the love and light, touch of change. Okay, you bring big change to people's lives. Okay, you touch. Your touch is very loving, whether it's showing it physically or just verbally. Okay, so this is really important. Write that list, because you will find that there's quite a lot of people in your life. Like I said, dark attracts light. You're attracting a lot of dark energy. I mean, the amount of people I've had to cut off recently. I mean, when you get to my age, you think to yourself, Jesus, I can't put up with this no more. But like, I had a friend that would come visit, and Jesus, when they left, it would be like, I'd be like, oh, they were like an energy vampire. It was like my energy was constantly always being sucked by this person, you know. And that's what I feel like for you guys, Group 3, this is happening with people around you as well. So what else would you like to say to Group 3? What message do you have, Spirit? I do apologise about the gardening. I've got gardener in today. Nothing is lost. Know that when you lose something, try to remember that there is always a deeper meaning, that anything you lose comes around in another form. No matter how bad things may seem, all is not lost. So this can be a friend, okay? This may be a friend that you fell out with and you still miss this person, but Spirit is saying nothing was lost here, okay? And then we've got in alignment. Everything is aligning perfectly in your life. What didn't make sense in the past will now start to fall into place. Okay, maybe you still question what went wrong here. What did I do? You know, but it's all for the greater good here. Okay, I love this card. Absolutely love that card. Oh, anyway. Oh, and that one. New beginnings. Time to start something new and trust the magic of beginnings. It's in your hands right now to change your story. Okay, maybe you've got to move away from people like this or this energy here. Awakening, you're getting to know who you truly are on a soul level. Take things slow as you begin to shift the way you interact with the world around you. Now that will literally clarify that some of you are coming into a spiritual awakening here, okay? You're on your life journey here, your life path, and I feel like you guys are actually on the right path, okay? You're not getting distracted, but sometimes we can get distracted because of the dark energies that surround us, okay? I mean, that's the devil energy is there to do that to light beings, okay? So, wait a minute, I was just about to say goodbye, but no. So, think of a question, or ask a question out loud and see what Spirit says. Alright, see what Spirit says. Outlook doesn't look good. So whatever it is that you are, Spirit saying it doesn't look good, the outlook of it, the end result of it, okay? So Group 3, I'm going to leave it there. If you like this reading, please hit like. It really helps the channel. If you're new here, please consider subscribing. I would love to have you. So anyway, guys, have a lovely day. Much love.